For 17 years already, you've been gathering this conference about fighting terror. How significantly, first of all, has things changed, conference number one to conference 17?
You know, terrorism is an evolving phenomenon. It changes from day to day, from year to year. The challenges that we faced last year when we gathered hundreds of experts in this conference exactly a year ago were different challenges that we are facing today. A year ago, ISIS was victorious. A year ago, you had foreign fighters coming from all over the world to join ISIS. Today, ISIS is suffering from defeat after defeat. We are now struggling with the question here at the conference, what would be the nature of Syria? What would be the nature of Iraq? What would be the nature of ISIS in the coming years?
So when you look at the fact that ISIS is not as victorious as it used to be, is it because people or the good guys are doing things right, or just that's how things turned out to be?
Well, counterterrorism is a very complicated subject matter. I use the term the art of counterterrorism. You need to be an artist in order to be effective in counterterrorism. No doubt that the defeats that ISIS has today in Syria and Iraq from the military side are going to cause the caliphate to fall down. But ISIS is not going to disappear. ISIS will change its nature. ISIS will become either a network like Al-Qaeda changed to be a network, or a network of networks, if you wish, or ISIS will find another territory in order to flourish, say Libya, Pakistan, Afghanistan, and other places around the world. The challenge of the counterterrorism experts is not just to observe that, to understand that, to analyze, but also maybe even to predict what's going to happen. At the end of the conference on Thursday, we are going to have a war game in which we will try to get into the minds of ISIS and understand what they will find merit in the future activities.
Interesting, you're saying going into minds of terrorists, because one of the assumptions is that there's no logic behind it, and you can't convince them to get out of it. There's religion, there's craziness.
Thank you for the question, because if there is one thing that I really want to share with your viewers, is the argument that we are talking about the art of counterterrorism. And maybe the most important knowledge of an artist of counterterrorism is the ability to understand the rationality of the opponent, the rationality of the enemy, the rationality of the terrorist. I'm working in the field of counterterrorism for the last 35 years. One thing I can tell you, if not all, then definitely most of the terrorists which I'm familiar with are rational actors. But they have a different rationality. They have a different calculus of cost and benefit, which is based on their religion, on their tradition, on their experience, or their interest, you name it. The task of the artist of counterterrorism is take off his own head, his own calculus of cost benefit, and replace that with the calculus of the terrorists themselves.
Let's end really with the state of Israel in this field. If we came here 10 years ago, we did, and we talked about this issue, and Israel, it's obvious that people or throughout the world want to learn from Israel. Is it the same now, or, you know, really people are dealing with terrorism? It's not that they're coming here and talking to Israel and hearing from Israel about what only happens here.
Today, people are much more eager to listen to what Israel have to say, to learn about the Israeli experience. But we need to be humble. Maybe unfortunately, other states are gathering more and more experience in counterterrorism as they suffer more and more from terrorist attacks. So we are learning from them as well. And I think that as Israelis, we definitely need to teach, but we need to learn at the same time.